So you've been seeing me retouching photos on this channel, but I've never shown you how I prepare my photos for retouching, right? So in this video, I'm going to show you simple yet powerful adjustments that I do to my photos before I retouch them. And the software that I'm using, or the software that I've been using, it's called Luminar Neo. This is a very powerful AI software. It's simple and also very easy to use. I'll show you what I mean by that in a bit. And if you guys want to check this software out, I'll put the download links in the description below. Let's do this. So let me just show you how to import the photos in this software. So I'm going to go to catalog here, and then I'm going to select add photos here. If I want, I can add a folder, or I can just add a single photo. So I'm going to just click here. So I'm going to look for the photo that I want to edit, but I'm just going to double click on the photo, or I can just click on open here. So our photo is loaded in Luminar Neo. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go on edit here. The software is going to look like this. This is a simple software, but it's a very powerful software. Before I do anything, I'm going to go on my histogram here. You can see this circle here. If I click on it, you can see the blue color here. It's telling me that this part is pure black. Everything that's in blue is pure black. And then I'm going to click on this other circle here. I'm going to go on essentials here, and then I'm going to select develop. If I take the exposure all the way this side, so you can see that this part is red, right? If I disable this, you won't see anything. But if I enable this, you see red here. This is telling me that this part is pure white. These circles are just going to guide me to see the places that are pure black and the places that are pure white. With that said, let me just reset this. So I'll start with the essentials here. I'm going to click on it. So from here, I'm going to open the develop raw here. I'm just going to click on it like this. So I'll start with the camera profile here. You can see on profile here, by default, it's going to be on Luminar default. So I'm just going to click on it so that I can see other profiles that we have here. So we have Adobe Standard, we have all these profiles. I'm not going to go through everything here. So you can see what's happening here. If I change a profile like landscape, you can see how it's changing this side. I'm going to select the profile that I'm going to like. Let me just go with Adobe Standard. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to play with the exposure. I just feel like the image is too dark. So I'm going to drag the exposure slider this side to maybe, I'm looking at the image. If I go overboard, since I've enabled these circles, I'll be able to see the places that are overexposed and the places that are pure black. So I'm going to double click on this circle here to reset the whole thing. Let me just double click it. I'll start moving the exposure slider just a bit. I'll stop at the point where I feel like the image is okay with me. 0.98 is okay. So for smart contrast, I think, let me just show you what this one does. If I move it like this, it's going to add some contrast to the image. If I take it like this, it's going to remove some contrast to the image, but I'm going to double click on it to reset it. I'll come back to this later. Let me just move here. I'm going to move to the highlights. So I'll take the highlights down to maybe negative 15 is okay. And then for the shadows, I'm just going to drag the shadows here so that I can just open up the places that are a little bit dark. I think 5 is okay for the shadows. I'm just going to open the blacks and whites here. If I slide the whites down here, I'm removing the whites from the image. If I drag it this side, I'm adding the whites in the image. I don't want this. I'm just going to double click on it to reset it. Same thing with the blacks. If I take it down here, I'm adding the blacks. You can see the blue color here. It's telling me that all these parts are pure black. If I disable this, you can see that these parts are pure black. Let me just enable this. So I'm going to reset it like this. So for these two sliders, I'm just going to leave it the way they are. I'll move to my favorite, the curves. So I'm going to move to the curves here. Instead of adding the contrast using the smart contrast, I'm going to add the contrast to the image using the curves. So this circle here is for the shadows. So if I take it this side, the image will be darker. If I take it this side,
the image will be brighter, right? Same thing with this circle here. If I take it this side, the image will be brighter. If I take it down here, the image will be darker, right? So let's take it back to where it was. So let me just make a point here, or make another point this side. So I just drag this a little bit up like this, and then I drag this a little bit down, and this one up like that. So let me show you. This is our before, this is our after, this is our before, this is our after. I'm going to go to the color here. Let me just open it here. I'm going to move down here. On the color here, we have the white balance here. So I'm going to leave it the way it is, as short by default. So I'll start with the temperature. If I take it this side, I'm making the image cooler. As you can see, the image is becoming blue. If I take it this side, I'm making the image warmer. The image is becoming orange. I'm going to double click on this circle like this to reset it. I want to make this image just a little bit cooler. So I'm going to take my white balance to 5200 kelvins. So I can double click here, and then I can just punch in the numbers that I want. So I'm going to type 5200 kelvins here. So I'm going to move to tint. If the image was looking like this, I could have just moved it to the magenta, the opposite side. Or if the image was looking like this, with a little bit of the magenta on top, I can just move it to the opposite side. But I'm just going to reset it. I'm going to double click on the circle. I'm going to open the optics here. I'm going to click on auto distortion correction here. It's going to correct the distortion in the image. So I'm going to check the auto fix chromatic aberration here. I'm going to click on it. I'm going to check even this one like this. You can play with these by just clicking on them. In my case, the image is not changing that much. If I enable these, the image is not changing that much. Now let me show you the powerful tools that I love in this software. We move to the creative here. So the first thing that we have here, this is my favorite, the rewrite here. So this is an AI adjustment. Let me show you what this one does. So let's say I want to make the background a little bit darker, right? So I'm going to go on these adjustments. On the brightness far here, this slider, if I take it down like this, let's just wait for the software to do some calculations and do the adjustments for us. How cool is this? So this is a before, this is a after, this is the before, this is a after. So if I want to make my background brighter, I can just drag this bright far this side here. It's going to make my background brighter, but I don't want that. I want my background to be darker. So I'm going to maybe drag it down. Negative 20 is okay. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So if I want to make my subject a little bit brighter, I'm going to select the brightness near. So I'm going to drag this side. It's going to make my subject brighter. If I take it down here, it's going to make my subject darker. Let me just reset it to the way it was. I like the way my image is looking right now. So I'm just going to close it. And then I'm going to move to the portrait here. I'm going to open it. We have the portrait bokeh. We have the face. We have the skin. We have the body. We are not going to do anything with the portrait bokeh. We'll skip this and then we'll move to the face. So you can see AI here. If I open this, whatever I'm going to do here, the software is going to do some calculations and then it's going to do some magic on the image. So we have the face light here. Let me just slide it this side, right? So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. How cool is this? Let me just reset it. Let me just add a little bit of some face light just for the sake of this video so that you see how powerful this software is. Let me just take it to 15. This is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. And then we have this slider, slim face. So if I move it this side, it's making my model's face slimmer. This is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. How cool is this? Let me just reset it. So I'm just going to leave it the way it is. I was just showing you what you can do with this. I'll move to eyes here. And then we'll move to enlarge eyes. Let me just move it down here. And then enlarge eyes. If I move it like this, I'll stop at 70. I wait for the software to do some computing and to do some magic on the image. You see, so this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If I want, I can take it to 100%. The eyes are now larger. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If I want, I can leave it the way it is, but I'm going to take it to the way it was. And then we have the eye whitening. So we can't see because the model's eyes are a little bit closed. If I take it to 100% like this, the software should make the eyes brighter. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Since my model's eyes are a little bit closed, you can't see what's happening here. Let's just move to the mouth here. We'll start with the lips saturation here. Let me just zoom it in. And then I'll try to move it to maybe 80%. We've just added saturation on the model's lips. Let me just show you the before and after. Let me just close the eyes here. Let me just move it up. So this is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. Let me just reset it. The lips redness. Let's take it this side. It's also adding the redness here, but you can use the brush to just paint this out. Just click on the mask here, select the brush, select the erase, and then you can just paint out like that. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. The lips redness, let me just reset it to 0. We'll move to the lips darkening. Let me just move it here. So it's making the lips darker. So let me show you the before and after. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. I think I like this. I'm going to leave it like this. Let me just reduce it just a little bit to 30. I'm going to select the mask. I'm going to select the erase. And then I'll just make the brush smaller using the brackets on the keyboard. And then I'll just paint on the hand here. I don't want this hand to be darker. So I'll just paint it like that. So if I move the teeth whitening slider this side, it should make my model's teeth whiter. So let's move it here. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let's just close the face here. Let's move to the skin. Let's just zoom out because we are dealing with the skin of our model. So if I move this amount slider all the way to 100, the software is making our model's skin smooth. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. I'm going to reset it, and then I'm going to move to remove shine here. So you can see this part is a little bit shiny. So if I want to remove the shininess from these parts, I can just drag the shine removal this side. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. How cool is this? I'm going to reset this like this. We have the body here. Let me just close this. We have the body here. Even though this image is not a full body portrait. So let me just take this to 100% and see what's going to happen. So I'm going to reset this. If I take it this side, so before, this is after, it's the before, it's the after. With just these adjustments, my photo is now ready for retouching. So this is our before, this is our after, this is our before, this is our after. We are done. And if you just want to check out this software, like I said, the links will be in the description below. I'll see you in the next one.